So I went through and asked the computer, read all the newspapers for me. I can't be like Bob Dylan in the microfilm. Read all the newspapers for me. What were the words that were used most often? And here's what they say in the North. Actually, I lifted this from a New York Times article that they used from the Academy Awards. And the big word was thank you. And then went back down, mom, you know, all that, it got smaller. The bigger the word here, the more they're using it. This is what they're saying in the North. They're talking about the Union. And the soldiers and the army calls this a war party, just like today, Republicans and Democrats at each other's throats. Republicans, Confederate, Lincoln, Negro. You look up there, and emancipation is written in the very small words up there. You don't really see, and so that what we think the war is about looks a little suspicious. And so what would say if we look at the Southern side? This is what we read, if we read the Southern newspapers, this is what they're talking about. And what strikes you about this? Exactly the same, except with one difference. It's us versus them. It's Confederate versus Union. And Union, soldiers, army, duty, Lincoln, battle, God, secession, rights, honor. These are the words, and you can sit in one afternoon, sit down and ask the computer to read all these newspapers, see what is it they're talking about the most. Then I say, go read all the letters and diaries. Tell me what you see. The pattern's pretty clear here, too. The North and the South, just as Bob Dylan says, speaking the same language, invoking the same God, even as they kill each other. God, duty, honor, union. Those are the words that they're using over the course of the war. Okay, now here's the mystery, though. Go through and count all these. How do these words change over the course of time? At the beginning of the war, slavery is all over the place, just as our textbooks tell us that they're fighting about slavery, but then slavery disappears as a word. And the people who are talking about it the most, these Northern Democrats, this color, what it is, the people who are talking about it the most are talking about it in order to attack it. Talking about black people, the word they would have used at the time, Negro, talk about it as little as they possibly can until the war has ended and black people become a problem. And then, look here, look who's talking about it. Here it is, the Northern Democrats who are using it to attack their opponents, the Northern Republicans and all this. Look at this, emancipation. Most important event in the war, the thing that redeems the war. It's mentioned in 1862 when it happens, and then the Republicans do their best to play it down. The Democrats don't want to play it down. They want to say in the elections of 63 and 4 and 5, aha, this is the party that freed the colored people down south. Is that what you sent your 18-year-old son down there to fight for? And they think they can get political gains from it. And as all students of the Civil War know, 1864, because of the military victories in Atlanta and the Shenandoah Valley, Lincoln is able to win, but he thought it was in spite of the Emancipation Proclamation. So this is turning our normal story of the Civil War upside down. The normal story is that, okay, it's true the war did not begin to end slavery. But over the course of the war, Americans grew. This is the story Ken Burns tells, that Americans got better. They realized, what were we thinking? Slavery was terrible. Let's go ahead and drive it to an end with this war. When you look at the patterns of the language, it suggests that that was not the case, that emancipation peaked early and actually diminished over time. Instead, what takes its place? What do people talk about more and more? They talk about duty. And the North and the South are using exactly the same words. What do you have a duty to do? We have a duty to fight for the Union or the Confederacy. What are you fighting for? The Union or the Confederacy? Why? It's our duty. And in some ways, they're draining the ideological purpose out of the war, and the war becomes much more about staying loyal to the cause than it is about any ideological purpose. You may not be able to tell, but all the things I'm saying right now are deeply controversial. And I just hope that none of the people who really disagree with me are in the room. And if they are, it'll make for a good conversation a little bit later. But these are things that I had no idea in this archive that Will and I had built ourselves. I didn't know what these patterns would show, and what they show is a pattern that is surprising, that the pattern that's embedded in the words that are hidden there is something we would not have expected.